Greetings. I began a series of letters to my Muslim brothers and sisters because I believe deep in their hearts they want the truth. And in their quiet moments, when they are honest with themselves, perhaps they can realize they are dissatisfied. Islam offers a form of piety, ritual, and obligation, but no meaningful satisfaction. In fact, it is impossible for Islam to ever offer meaningful satisfaction. Without question, it can offer a purpose. ISIS, the Islamic State, exemplifies a purpose, but not a meaningful, righteous purpose. I just said it was impossible for Islam to ever offer meaningful satisfaction. And I'm sure if you call yourself Muslims, you think you have satisfaction. If that were true, if Islam could offer legitimate, meaningful purpose, Islam would not require threats and violence to stop apostasy. Islam would not need to silence and threaten other voices that refute its claims. Islam could allow, could tolerate different ideas, could win in the marketplace of ideas. After 15 years of studying Islam, I have never met a Muslim who could honestly, accurately handle the Word of God. Not one. And that is one damning condemnation of Islam's retarding effects. But it really is Satan's lies that blind and trap Muslims in a state of ignorance. I do not think the problem is the Muslims themselves. The problem is Islam itself. The problem is the Quran itself. You see, there is nothing that Islam has produced that the world wants. Even Muslims are fleeing Islamic lands in record numbers, which is really driven by two agendas. One agenda is survival, as Sunni kill Shia, who kill Sunni in return. But those that flee still want to invade and impose Sharia, impose Islam. The fools leading the USA are now seeding jihad all across America, planting small Syrian Muslim communities, even in places like Wyoming. Both history and modern Europe provide evidence they will refuse to integrate, refuse to become citizens who support the nation. The second group are those who intentionally are invading to act as sleeper terrorists. Again, they ultimately want to impose Sharia, impose Islam, because the true nature of Islam is war against all who have not submitted to Satan, Allah. I know the Dawa and claims that Islam is based on salam, which means peace. But those are empty words, refuted by the reality that Islam and Sharia has created. If Islam was so desirable, brother, why isn't the world beating a path to embrace it? Why is it only now, 1400 years after Muhammad created Islam, that it is exploding? The answer is the fullness of time. The time of the Gentiles is nearly fulfilled, nearly complete. Luke 21:24, they will fall by the edge of the sword and be led captive among all nations, and Jerusalem will be trampled underfoot by the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles are fulfilled. Some think this ended in 1967 when Jerusalem again became controlled by Israel. But the Temple Mount is still a pagan shrine, an abomination, controlled by Muslims who are Gentiles. Just maybe, The time of the Gentiles will end when Jews once again have their third temple. Will it be beside the pagan dome of Mohammedism? That is a topic for another video. The time of the Gentiles is nearly complete, and when it ends, watch out. And Jerusalem will be trampled underfoot by the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles are fulfilled. Then there will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars, and there will be anguish on the earth among nations, bewildered by the roaring sea and waves. Let he who has eyes to see pay attention to this whole verse. Then there will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. Remember the tetrad of blood-red moons? Is that sign in the moon by the sun so last year? The fourth one is coming up. Don't forget it, and don't get distracted. There will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. Remember the sign of Revelation 12:1 on September 23, 2017? Is that sign in the stars, moon, and sun too far away? Don't forget it, and don't get distracted. These are signs related to the end of the time of the Gentiles. Kind of like when you are watching a movie, and you wait until you finally see the words presented. The end. Well, that is nearly where we are on the timeline. Islam's tale is that Islam will dominate the world for the last day. The religion that claims there is no compulsion in religion will drop all pretense and deception and compel the religion of hell on all it can. And that is just as the Bible has foretold. Lord, may he who has eyes to see the role Islam plays in the last days. And there will be anguish on the earth among nations, bewildered by the roaring sea and waves. Like it or not, global warming by the sun was predicted in the Bible. And there will be anguish on the earth among nations, bewildered by the roaring sea and waves. Anguish on the earth among nations, bewildered by the roaring sea and waves. I suppose, academically, one could argue man is ultimately responsible. It was man's sin that burdened creation with corruption. Romans 8:19, "For the anxious longing of the creation waits eagerly for the revealing of the sons of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, vanity, frustration, and curse, not willingly, but because of him who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself also will be set free from its slavery to corruption into the freedom of the glory of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation has been groaning together with labor pains until now. And not only that, but we ourselves who have the Spirit as the first fruits, we also groan within ourselves, eagerly waiting for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. We have the Spirit of God, the Spirit of adoption. Now we await the redemption of our bodies." With the end of the time of the Gentiles, the world will suffer, unlike it has ever suffered. That time is not 10 years away. Now is the time to know your Lord. And look up, for your redemption draws near. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.